Hi, I'm Clay Carlino, and I do stuff. And what I'm doing today, even though it's today's a Monday, I am doing an impromptu live stream all about Astrotrain. Yes, Astrotrain, our favorite Decepticon. Okay, he may not be your favorite Decepticon, but he's... But he's got to be on somebody's list because he's really cool. I mean, he goes into space. He's a train. His name is Space Train, Astrotrain. So, let's just... Thank you. So, let's go ahead and let's dial things back a bit to 1985, when Transformers would have been on the air for 1 year, the franchise would have been in stores, and they would have been up to Wave 2, and we get the amazing new technology of triple changers. And so that brings us to this guy right here, and here he is, the guy who started it all, Gen 1 Astrotrain. And, you know, he's not got a bad robot mode. I mean, he's got dinky little arms. And let's go ahead and put this on the super close so that you can really appreciate this. He's got these little tiny arms. And you see how there's this line right here. And it really makes it look like these arms should extend out. But they do not. At some point I may try and take them apart just to see how they're put together, because it seems like they should, but no force that I could put on it would get those things to separate without breaking. So yeah, dinky little arms, and then a decent head sculpt, nothing to write home about, but not bad. He does have a full head. It's not a sticker face or anything like that. And then, a reasonable robot body. Of course, like many of the Gen 1 characters, he was a bit of a stick. You got some articulation in the arm, and, some articulation in the arm. And Joy is here! Holy crap! Joy is here! Well, Joy, a toast to you, Joy, for being on this very special live stream. For those viewers who are under the age of 21, this is Pink Lemonade, and it just happens to be very comforting Southern Pink Lemonade. Delicious, comforting Southern Lemonade. Vengeful. I don't know where to go with this. So anyway, we've got... So really a lot of sound effects tonight. So, we've got Gen 1 Astrotrain, and his transform is not too terribly complex, even considering that he has three modes. When I was a kid, the idea of a Transformer being able to transform into two different vehicle modes was crazy. So unfortunately I did not have Astrotrain until much later in life, so I couldn't, he was a mystery to me. But you flip the space shuttle end out of the feet, and, Nathan Fillion is here! Oh my gosh! Well, in that case, I have to, Yes, Mr. Fillion is threatening to tell my boss that I'm drinking on a work night, but Mr. Fillion, this is pink lemonade. That is, it's very lemony. This is the pink lemonade, and that's all we're going to show you of the label, but it is very special. So you flip the ends of the space shuttle out of the legs, and you might as well go ahead and collapse the legs while you're at it. And then you close up the top here, and you already have the wings out from the robot mode, and then you put together the chest flaps. You know, they were like this, and then they just close like this, and then the whole thing slides backwards like that. On the back, you've got booster rockets, so those snap up, and then this just nests in there. And look at that! That is a space shuttle, and it is definitively a space shuttle. I mean, you know, this looks the part, and sure, it's... No! yes, Mr. Fillion, the pink lemonade has a kick, but with secret sauce, yes. It always had this sort of box around here that normal space shuttles don't have. That's just sort of become part of the charm. And I know that when I was a kid, it kind of bothered me that he didn't look exactly like a space shuttle. But, you know, now it's so much a part of his identity that I feel like it adds character to the spaceship mode. And let's face it, space shuttles are kind of boring looking. I mean, they're real spaceships, but they aren't that cool looking. So, you know, this is awesome.
I like trains.
It is, so I guess we want to get to this train mode. This is not the SpaceX space shuttle because that had not been invented yet. This is about 30 years earlier. So, but let's go ahead and just roll on to the train mode. And so to do that, we're going to slide the tail forward, and that's... So we slide it forward like that. That's great. That's awesome. Here, we're going to slide this all the way down, and then we're just going to tuck it up into the nook here. There's a little slot here, and we're just going to tuck that in there, and then we're going to fold the wings up and fold them down against, and just kind of squeeze it sideways, and I feel like I can do a little bit more, slide that a little bit further forward. I'm going to try. It's a little bit tough, but there we go. Okay, so we got that, and then you flip the sides down like that, and then you fold out these little flaps and fold them down to the other side. And we are close here, ladies and gentlemen. You are gonna need to split, let's just open up the tops here and rotate around the nose cone of the space shuttle. It's going to take a little finessing. There's a little bit of a slot happening there. And there you go. We have a train. And look at that. I mean, that's convincing. As Transformer trains go, sure, it's got some divisions in it. But this is definitely... Let me tighten up. I've got some parts that need to kind of get squeezed together here. So... Okay, so. Yes, this is a train. Let's go to the super close. So, yeah, look at that. There is nothing wrong with that. And I love that they chose a steam locomotive and not a more modern diesel train. Because let's face it, diesel locomotives, or you know, coal locomotives, old-fashioned locomotives, gosh, I shouldn't have had so much of that lemonade, are just cooler looking than more modern trains. I don't know what it's going to take, but at some point, we need to redesign trains so that they're interesting again, because the more modern we get, the less cool they look. You know, they keep making them streamlined and smooth and... You know, somebody needs to put some apparatus on that stuff, okay? Yes! Yes! So, yeah, if you are a train designer, here, inspiration. Come on. And you know what? Go with a purple and black color scheme. You'll get extra points from Transformers fans. So this is Astrotrain in his train mode, and he looks pretty good. And I think that's about all we have to say. In the cartoon, he was always transporting all the Decepticons, even though he was like that big. But you know what? That's what imagination is for. So. Then when the Transformers Generations line, or when it first came out, it was called Transformers Classics. And that was, it was a while ago. I'm going to say around the turn of the century was when Transformers Classics first debuted. And, you know, somewhere in there. Yes, you know what? Mr. Fillion is correct. We just add a flux capacitor on this baby and it travels through time. It was the single coolest part of Back to the Future 3, which I know, Mr. Fillion, you didn't really like that movie because you don't like westerns, but you have to admit, time traveling train, awesome. So, the Classics line came out where they reimagined Gen 1 characters and... Oh, 2007. Wow. Okay, so 2007, Transformer Classics comes out. We finally see Hasbro really embracing their retro heritage and reimagining Gen 1 characters with new innovative designs and carrying into those designs some of the new practices. You know, articulation and posability became important, as well as detail and creating likenesses that were reminiscent of the old G1 cartoon. They knew who their target buying audience was. I had to add my own sound effect. I'm sorry, sweetie. So that brought us Classics Astrotrain, and he does look good. Are we done? So, we have Classics Astrotrain, and he is dynamic. He's got knee joints and hip joints, and his legs are twist and turn, and his arms have elbows, and look, his arms are actually, like, a respectable length, and he's got a great Gen 1 head sculpt. Let's go to the super close. So, you know, he looks Gen 1 accurate. He's still got that telltale... Tail deco in the chest, which was never featured on the cartoon, which is kind of sad because that was a big part of the toy. He's also got shoulders this time. The shoulders look great. We have 6 people watching. It's Monday. Hold on. Whoa. Oh, wait here. You can't see me toast if I'm on the super close. So we got 6 people watching on a Monday. So, that's for you. My other 4 people that joined on a Monday. Oh boy, we better not take too long on this, cause. But I am gonna set this over there, and if more pink lemonade ends up in that glass, then more pink lemonades ends up in that glass. I'm just saying. So, yeah, he looks great. He's posable. I'm only lukewarm to the white color scheme. I mean, it's neat. It's kind of a nice difference. It's certainly more space shuttle-y, but you know, I want to see him in gray and purple. That's how I imagine him, gray and purple. So let's go ahead and take off his gun for a second here, and we're just going to go ahead and transform him into the space shuttle mode. And that's not too hard. You're gonna put the legs together like this, and then you're gonna take the nose cone off of the side of the feet, swing them around like this, and pinch them together. And then he's got the fronts of his feet, which just fold down, and that makes the end of the space shuttle. And then the whole thing collapses, just like that. And see, we're almost there already. So then we're going to squeeze the arms, which the arms really want to squeeze anyway. It's even in robot mode, these side panels just constantly want to slide in and cover his fists. It's a little bit of a flaw, but I'm not going to be hard on him. So, I'm not going to be too hard on him. I'm not going to be too critical. Critical is the word that I was looking for. And then, once again, this seems to be... This is a pretty common thing for the thrusters to be on the back and then to somehow go over the head. However, his head does need to come out of the way, so you open up this panel on the back and fold the head down just like that, close up the panel, and then now you can take the thrusters, close them against the back, and then you just kind of peg in these side thrusters onto the sides of the body of the space shuttle. And can I get it? It's gonna go somewhere in there. Yes, almost. I can see it there. Okay, so It's a space shuttle. You know what? If I were Astrotrain, regardless of what mode I was in, I would just honk my train horn all the time. And I can see that Monica would too. So, this is the space shuttle, and it looks awesome! This is an excellent space shuttle mode! You know, If the paint detail were a little bit more realistic and maybe we had different colors on the thrusters and, you know, some things like that, then this would be amazing. And even as, let's look, landing gear. We've got landing gear. Kyoji is here! Everyone, okay, here's one for Kyoji. Hey, Kyoji, welcome! You soften that up a little bit. Yes. We don't need me to be unable to work tomorrow. Right, Mr. Fillion? That's right. So, that's the space shuttle mode. Let me put it on the super close, see if you can get some better details of that. But you can see it looks great. Of course, the classics line had the rub signs. So you put your finger on there and then, oh my gosh, it's a Decepticon. I would have never guessed. And obviously these are part of the train deco, but it looks really good in the space shuttle mode. It looks like it belongs. It's very tight. You know, the joints are very close. The tolerances are tight. This is a great toy. And I have to say that all things considered, in every conceivable way, I think that this so far is an improvement over the original. And that's a bold statement. But so far, two modes better than the original. So, except for the colors. Okay, it loses. But you know what? As a space shuttle, this does look you know, that's appropriate. So let's go ahead and look at the train mode. And
I like trains.
We do like trains, and apparently we really like trains on this channel. Okay, honestly, of course we like trains on this channel. Does anybody have any doubts that we like trains on this channel? So, what we're gonna do here is we're gonna take the thrusters back and pivot the wings down. And then we're going to take those side thrusters, swing them around, and connect them behind the body of the shuttle. There we go. And then we're going to flatten the tail. You know, the tail just splits. If you can get your fingernail in there, which I chewed mine off while trying to fix my computer earlier today. But it seems to be working now, which is why I'm able to do this live stream. Oh, I can't get my fingers in there. There we go. Okay, so you split those right there. And then, oh, we fold up the landing gear. And then we're going to fold the wings against the front of the space shuttle. And then, this is also a familiar maneuver. The wings folding over the body of the train, and then we take the thrusters, swivel them around, and close them against the back, because one of the characteristic things about every mode of Astrotrain is that the back end of the train still has the thrusters. And I think that's awesome! I mean, way to embrace it. So that is the train mode, and you know, I don't want to say it's a bad train mode because it actually looks great. It really does. I mean, this looks awesome. Let's go to the super close. Okay, look at that. You know, look at the detail. Look at the little windows. I mean, this looks like a bullet train. It works really well in this mode, and you know, the detail is nice, and the tolerance is nice, and it looks intentional. So, you know, it's hard to be overly critical. Oh, I guess I have to, there. So it's hard to be overly critical, and they've even got little rollers on the bottoms of the wings here, and then they've got some rollers here. Well, they're molded in, they don't actually roll. And then they've got some rollers here. So, you know, it's... Oh, yeah, we can compare these to the Autobot bullet train from Car Robots. And, you know, every one of these, it fits in. It's even in the same scale. I mean, you know, look, I got a handful of bullet trains here. This is the Autobot rail team, and no, I'm not going to transform them on this live stream, because we will be here all night. But, yeah, you know, Astrotrain fits right in with these guys. So this is, and we can take the gun and put it right there if we want to give the train some ammunition. So it's a good train mode, but it's not a locomotive. I like the locomotive. And I get what they did here, and I respect what they did here, but you know, I love that locomotive. It was so awesome! And you know, all the, you know, the cylindrical thing and all the tubes and everything. I mean, there's just nothing that beats a locomotive design. And that's not really a fault of the designers of this, that bullet trains aren't as cool as locomotives. Okay, let's see, Joy was just saying, ride on the peace train. So thank you, Joy. Yeah, ride on the peace train. It's really loud here. It's really, really loud. Okay, good. Well, this is quite a live stream that you've tuned into. I'm so sorry. So, I'm not gonna hold it against the design that it's a bullet train, but gosh, this is really cool. It's really cool. This is probably a better toy, but boy, look at that train. So, that is Classics Astrotrain. We did get another Astrotrain at during Titan Returns, and I can probably pull that up on the internet, but you know, it's not that interesting. I got the version that was what's his name, one of the primes, the orange guy, Sentinel Prime. I think that it was Sentinel Prime. Yeah, I got the mold that was Sentinel Prime, and then later they released the Astrotrain, knowing that I would really want the one in Gen 1, but I didn't like the toy enough to get two versions of the same mold. So, you know, I didn't get that one. It's okay, because just this year, with Transformers Earthrise, we got Astrotrain. Transformers Earthrise Astrotrain. Now, this guy has a monumental design. You look at him and the detail is amazing. Let's go to the super close. So, you know, let's start with the head sculpt. He looks great. You know, all the detail and textures in his body, he looks Gen 1 accurate, except far more realistic. He's poseable. He's got articulated joints, and he's got the ankle joints. You can pivot the head. He's got weapons that combine. You know, this is like some kind of super weapon, and it comes apart and makes all sorts of extra guns, and still more guns, and then more guns, and oh, a missile launcher, for variety's sake. And then we've got Astrotrain here that has some apparatus on his back. And, we're going to talk about the apparatus on the back. In robot mode, it just doesn't do much. And, you know, he's actually better off if you just take it off. Now, part of this is these feet extensions that make him just a little bit taller. And they're kind of useful because if you have that big backpack on him, he needs the extra footprint width to keep from falling over backwards. But you take these things and you can put them together like that. And then there's these little holes in here and these little pegs right here. And this just clicks together like that. And so what they've got here, let's go ahead and spin this thing a little bit, maybe. Okay, wait, here, there. Spin, and what it does is this piece turns into a coal car for the train mode, which I think is awesome. That is really cool. That is fantastic. I love that they gave him a car, and so... And so let's go ahead and turn him into a train. Actually, it might be easier to go to turn him into a space shuttle first, and then we'll go to the train. So we're going to go to the space shuttle, and he's fiddly. He is fiddly. He's got a lot of fiddliness. You end up bending the arms up like this and folding down the wrists to collapse inside the forearms. Just like that. Of course, we're also going to, we're going for space shuttle, right? Yes. Oh, we're up to 8 viewers? Whoa, okay, 8 viewers on a Monday night? This is for you. A toast to 8 viewers who are watching me on a Monday night. You guys are awesome. And we've got train noises. We got a lot of train noises. Thank you. I think that last one could have been louder, actually. So, you know, she had turned down the train noises, thinking that we didn't need loud train noises. Yeah, okay, there we go. So, we're going for space shuttle. So you flip, you didn't see me flip the feet around. They go on the back of the leg here. And then the inside of the foot has the space shuttle ends, and you're actually going to take the entire side of the leg and pivot it up and out around to expose that. You're also going to need to flip around the nose cone, just like that, and then you put the two nose cones together. You take these flaps that go in front of his hips, and they fold up and lock against his belly. And then, Joy says that the word of the day is fiddliness. Thank you, Joy. And so whenever we hear the word fiddliness, we drink some pink lemonade. Okay, so yes. Fiddliness.
I like trains.
There's really, I don't need to say anything. We could just keep going for another hour with nothing but train sound effects, and I know I would be happy. I don't know about you, but I would be happy. So, and ever notice how sometimes I'll stall when I don't know exactly what the next step is on a Transformer? Well, yeah, thank you, yes. So let's see, somewhere around here, we gotta do something. And I'll be honest, I'm not exactly sure what goes next. Oh, wait. Okay, thank you. That helped. So here's what's going on. You need to rotate the arms around so that they're coming up on the outside. You see, you put them up like this, arms forward, and then the forearms go up against, and you see there's a little notch right there, or a little peg that goes into a notch on the forearm, just like that. And then that allows this to close above his head like that. And then, oh yes, now I'm remembering things, that's good. He's also, look at how tight the tolerances are. Wait, I'm gonna go to the super close because you need to see this. Okay, so you look at the side here, and these pieces look like just one molded pattern, but actually, this little thing right here is a catch for your thumbnail. And that pivots up just like that, and then you do the same thing on the other side, and then this whole piece pops out like that.
Surprise, motherfucker!
Exactly! And that gives you the tail, and that also covers up the head. So that goes in just like that, and then the back end with the wing is going to close up against the back of the robot, which makes the bottom of the space shuttle. And I know this is going to come as a shock, but the thrusters are on his back and they pivot up and around and close up against the back of the ship. Ooh, and I just crushed the front. So, you know, once again, and I really like that there's a legacy of design movements that have carried over with this character. It's sort of like when Optimus Prime's arms transform and fold into the side of his body. It's something where a motion has become a distinct part of a Transformer's identity. And that's fantastic. The achievement of being able to assign an experience to a character. you know, that's unheard of. And Hasbro's designers are obviously very well aware that that's happening because they're carrying these things over again and again, saying, yeah, we know. And so, you know what? Thank you. And also, the muscle memory is comfortable and nostalgic. So Monica was just saying that the muscle memory is comforting and nostalgic. And it is. You know, I love the fact that even when transforming this much more involved, much more complicated character, there's still familiarity there. It's reminiscent of my childhood, and even the larger scale makes it feel, in relative terms, similar to what I had when I was a kid. So, yeah, kudos to the Hasbro designers for picking up on these subtle nuances and not just making a toy that is a triple changer that goes from robot to space shuttle to train, but really honing in on the distinctive qualities that made that character popular in the first place. So anyway, you remember those side panels that were on the legs? Those are going to collapse around the upper portion of the legs, just like that. And I got a little bit of fiddliness on the back here. One of my feet came undone. And I said fiddliness!
I like trains, motherfucker.
So, wow, it got real. See, his foot doesn't want to peg in, and I'm trying to get it to peg in. There we go. Okay, so this is the space shuttle mode, and it looks awesome. It really does look awesome, but they took some liberties here. Look at the back end. You know, look at all of this kind of raw looking stuff. And on one hand, I kind of like it, but on the other hand, it really stands out as not fitting with the rest of the ship's design. It looks unfinished. It looks like there's something missing from the rest of him, but that's actually how he transforms. And it's a conceit. They've achieved a lot with the design, but I will say that detracts a little bit from the aesthetics. Now, we also have this coal car. Now, what can you do with a coal car? Well, in this case, the coal car opens up like this, and then it makes a launch platform for the space shuttle. Okay? Look at that! That's freaking awesome! And of course you can put, you know, you can put guns all over him. We'll put some guns on him. Because as Michael Bay taught us in Armageddon, when he was making movies that didn't piss me off, space shuttles are only cool if they have lots of guns on them. So there we go. We got a heavily armored Decepticon space shuttle. Oh, we got this thing. This thing can go on there somewhere too. There's a lot of 5mm holes to receive weapons, which is very, very cool. Let me put this on the other camera so that you can really appreciate what it looks like on a tabletop. And that's it. You know, that's actually really cool. That is an awesome thing. I love that it has a platform, you know, a liftoff platform. You know, that, and it also rolls, you know, and it's got these little molded in treads here that, you know, here and here. So it would roll. So that is him. But you take it off of here, and then, you know, if you've got this, this stays behind, I guess. There's really not a whole lot else that you can do. What you could do, let's see, we can fold it up turn it back into a train car. There we go. So it's a train car. And then we'll just... So this pivots so that you can make it fit however you need to. And we can attach it to the back of the space shuttle. And then it's a space train? What was... No, it doesn't really go underneath. There's a peg... Yeah. It doesn't really go underneath. It just, you could stick it on the back. They made a landing platform for him. So how critical do I want to be? Mr. Fillion is asking, why always Transformers? What about something else on my live stream? Well, I have lots of how-to videos that mostly involve fixing my cars. And, unfortunately, since I was a poor kid, I had to choose which franchise I was going to sell my soul to, and Transformers won. So,
freedom is the right of all sentient beings.
Yeah, Peter Cullen. So... Anyway, so that's the space shuttle mode, I'm just going to throw this out. So, let's go ahead and take all the weapons off. You've got space shuttle that obviously needs coverings, okay? You've got this thing, which is made out of, which, you know, is a whole bunch of flat panels, and of course... What they've done is they've put these universal sockets, which is part of this this line, and they are compatible with other Transformers in the line. So you see I've got Ironworks here, and he's got his platform, and then that sticks. And it also makes a hinge joint. Okay? So we've got a hinge joint right here that just snaps together, which, by the way, is not compatible with the same feature that they put into the Power of the Primes characters just a couple years ago. Okay, I need my eight people that have logged in to move away from their computers for just a moment. I'm talking to Hasbro. Hasbro? Why? Why would you change that connection? I bought your blaster toy. I bought your Power Master Optimus Prime that wasn't that good and paid too much for it. And you couldn't hook anything up to it because the ramps didn't go in a good place. Could you at least make this connection point compatible with that one? Would it kill you? I don't understand. You know, you've got this thing that you rolled out as a gimmick a second time, why not make it compatible with the one that you did just a couple years ago? I don't understand. Help me to understand. And here's the other thing. So we've got we've got this thing that's just made up of flat hinges. Well, why do these hinges have pins through them so that you can't pull these things apart and reconfigure them any way you want? Instead, you spent more money to put a metal hinge in there just so that I couldn't have more play value. What are you thinking? This is a no-brainer. Come on! You could have easily just put this hinge right here, this shape right here, in here, and here, and here, and here. And then as a user, I could pull this thing apart and reconfigure it and make a long track or do whatever. And that's criticism one. That's criticism one. Joy, I will answer your question in just a moment. I'm not going to forget about you. I'm still talking to Hasbro. Hasbro, you're not off that easy. You've got this thing. It's made up of flat panels. It's not that complicated. You got this thing. It's missing a bunch of flat panels. Why do none of these detach and just go on there? Look! Yeah! Yeah, the crowd's with me on this. Look, you could... See? You could actually finish your space shuttle if you had just made these things come off. So, of course, where this is leading is that eventually I will kit-bash this so that these panels come apart and they attach to the space shuttle and help to complete that fuselage. Or is that the right word? Fuselage? I think it's a fuselage. I like the word fuselage. I'm going to use it often in sentences.
I like trains.
And I also like trains. So, Joy asked the question, would Astrotrain or Godzilla win in a battle? Let's find out. We have Godzilla here. Godzilla is my special guest star. Godzilla, do you have anything to say to Joy about who would win between you and Astrotrain? Wait, does the mouth open? Wait, here we go. I believe that Godzilla would win in that fight because Godzilla destroys cities. Astrotrain turns into a train which operates in a city. So, yeah, I think that I kind of feel like that's no contest. Godzilla for the win. Fair? Ah, that's what I was hoping for. Thank you. And just as a sneak preview for those people who don't know already, on Friday we will be discussing more questions about Godzilla versus Transformers. It's going to be awesome. So, yeah, I don't understand why something so obvious was overlooked. I don't understand why these hinges aren't the same as these hinge points. Cheeky Cheeky Boy is here. I'm out of pink lemonade, but Cheeky Cheeky Boy, legitimate, like, diet green tea. It's absolutely not pee. Okay, yeah. So, you know, I never had sound effects for my green tea before, but that's pretty awesome. So, Joy was referring to classic Godzilla with the tongue action, and I'm afraid that classic Godzilla would absolutely trounce Astrotrain. No contest. Yeah. So, you know, for one thing, he's got fire breath, which could be a tongue. And he's also got a fist that shoots off. And I just punched my webcam in the face. I've never understood why Godzilla's fists would shoot off. I'm pretty sure that would hurt. But nonetheless, it does, and it works. And Astrotrain absolutely would not be ready for that. So... So, there we go. Moving onward and upward, or in this case, not necessarily upward, because we want to go to the ground. We want to take this space shuttle and put it on the ground. We're going to throw it on the ground. It's not part of my system, man. I'm an adult! I hope somebody out there gets that reference. I'm gonna feel bad if nobody does. So, we're gonna have to split the legs. There we go. And flip the nose cone of the space shuttle around. And then while his legs are apart, we're gonna have to pull out, there's a detail inside the nose cone that folds out. And this is what makes the headlamp on the front of the train. And then these go together like this, just like that. And see, that's already very train-esque. Yeah, that's a good word, too. If our word of the day wasn't already fiddliness, then the word train-esque would be. There we go. So, fiddliness!
I like train, motherfucker.
Okay. Pink lemonade, ladies and gentlemen. So, Joy, you are going to have so much fun with the next live stream. I promise you. Anyway, you're gonna collapse the legs back over the rest of the front of the train like that. Then you're gonna fold down the side panels. And once again, this is very, very reminiscent of the Gen 1 counterpart. And now there is a pivot in here that's intended for the robot mode so that when he's in robot mode, you can put this back like this. I don't like it as much like that. So when I showed it to you before, I had it like this, but it's there. So be aware, there's an extra pivot that really doesn't add anything. But hey, I'm not gonna criticize them for adding extra features if I choose not to use them. So, once again, we are going to fold the wings up. See, once again, very familiar motions to the transform. And then, again, the wing tips fold in, and you give them a little bit of a squeeze so that they can compress. And then this apparatus right here rotates around. Actually, I'm going to pick up these little side flaps. Rotate this around. Rotate this around, and now we'll close these down, and look at that. That is a train. That is a steam locomotive. It is detailed. Let's go to the super close. So let's just look at this guy. We've got, a nice train front. Oh, you know what? That's there. I couldn't get it to focus. I didn't know why. My lens wasn't in place. So, we've got a really nice train front. I mean, the detail is fantastic. And then we've got all these painted tubes and things molded into the side. And then we've got the train apparatus and the wheels. I mean, the detail just makes this guy come to life. And I very well may do some more detail painting just because I really like what they've done here. And of course, keeping with tradition, he's got the booster rockets in the back of the train. This is a labor of love. It really is. It looks awesome. Now, if you want to be nitpicky, you could point out, okay, there's little wheels here and here, and then you've got wheels here and here, so does it ride on four tracks? It's a locomotive that turns into a space shuttle. I really feel like logic already left the building. So, yeah, it's a little bit wider than what you would expect in a normal locomotive, but gosh, it's such a neat vehicle mode. It's hard for me to be overly critical. And we're not even seeing the best part. Now you take the landing thing here and you fold it up and you make a train car out of it. There we go. Very simple. And see, these three little pegs just plug into the three pegs on the back here. And look at that. That is so cool. Wait, or does it go? No, yeah, that's it. Look at that. That is cool. That is so cool. For years, I have wanted Astrotrain to have cars, and he's finally got a coal car. So that's amazing, and of course there's plenty of places to put weapons and things like that if you want to, and they can fall off, and there's lots of places to put stuff. But honestly, The train mode doesn't need a whole lot of embellishment. It's really cool, it's nicely done, and it's beefy. So that is Earthrise Astrotrain. Now let's just talk a little bit about the dollars and cents here. I go to Target and I see there's some of the toys that are at the $25 price point. And then I see the ones that are at the $29 price point. And then the next price point is $50. $50. This is not really, I mean, it's marketed, okay, it says that it's a leader class toy. It even says here, leader class, okay? I'm just gonna point out, this is a Voyager class toy with a few flat parts added, okay? This is not really a leader class toy. And, you know, same thing that they did with Optimus Prime, so this is Earthrise Optimus Prime, and he comes with this trailer, and that makes him a leader class toy. But this Optimus Prime is not really all that leader classy, and this trailer is diminutive. This is a tiny trailer, and the upside is that Cliff Jumper fits inside. But you see this, it is made very cheap and very small, and you know, yeah, you can take this thing off and you can put it on his back, and that's cool, but I mean, is it $50 cool? Is it jumping over the $40 price point cool? I think not. So yeah, I'm I understand that prices are always going to go up, and I just have to suck it up and deal with it. But, you know, I just feel like 50 is a pretty high point for this. 40 would be good. I'd be comfortable with 40. But 50 is higher than I really want to go. Obviously, I went there. So I hope that all of you watch this video over and over again and watch all the ads to help pay for the extra money that I paid. I just need to make $10 off of this video to make the difference between the $40 that I would have happily paid and the $50 that I had to pay. So there we go. But cost aside, it is a really nice toy. And the modes are great. The weapons are fun, and I really appreciate when they put these 5mm holes in the sides of the weapons that allow you to combine them in unique and interesting ways. You know, I would like to see them do a lot more of this kind of stuff. Yeah, I feel like versatility is the lifeblood of the Transformers line, and they need to embrace it. They need to stop putting unnecessary hinge pins in stuff to prevent you from putting it together wrong. Let kids put it together wrong, Hasbro! Let them have fun! Let them come up with their own configurations for these parts that might be better than the ones that you and your very talented designers come up with! That is what that turns these toys into not just a storytelling device, and not just a problem-solving educational tool, but also a means of creative expression. And it will elevate your brand to new heights. It will put you on the same platform as Lego. And you know what? Lego's something good to achieve for. And you can do it. I know you can. So, next time around, I want to see these hinge points used here, 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 and here. I want to be able to pull this thing apart, not because I'm doing something that I'm not supposed to, but because you've given me the flexibility to do it any way I want. And you know what? I think that my 9-year-old counterparts would feel the same way.
Freedom is the right of all sentient beings.
So, that's it. This is not a long live stream. This was just kind of a spur-of-the-moment thing to see if anybody actually logged on and to talk about Astrotrain before I start cutting pieces off of him and drilling holes in him. Which is gonna happen real soon, I think. Alright, it is Monday night. I have to work in the morning. Everybody, have a wonderful evening. Is there anything else that I need to add? I don't see anything. Alright, so thank you so much. Thank you, Cheeky Cheeky Boy. Thank you, Joy Thayer. Thank you, Nathan Fillion. Thank you, everyone, for tuning in on a Monday night. This is Clay Carlino telling you to be brave. Cut into your toys and yell at Hasbro when they don't want you to.